Hello, this short video will explain the basics of the MyDaytonaState portal and important features that you should be aware of. The easiest way to get there is by entering www.daytonastate.edu in your preferred browser. Then choose MyDaytonaState from the upper right-hand corner. This is where you will go to log in to your student account. You can also choose the icon above the academic calendar links to get there as well. Every student has an automatically defaulted username. It consists of your first name underscore last name. If you have a common name, such as John Smith, you may have additional numbers after your last name as a part of your username, for example, John underscore Smith 1234. When you admitted to the college, you received an email with this username, and a letter was mailed to the address we have on file that you provided to us. The password is defaulted as well. The layout for the default password is found below the sign-in. We strongly recommend changing the password to something personal and secure, but also easy to remember. We also ask that you immediately set your secret questions and answers now in the event that you forget your password and need to reset it. By having your questions set up, you can reset your own password via self-service rather than requiring assistance from our IT help desk. It is a real time saver and helps you avoid inconvenience and frustration. If you don't want to do it now, you can always go to www.daytonastate.edu/help. And there are tutorials and handouts to help you with this and many other processes. This is the help page, and you can manage your password here. Once you have logged on, notice the Help option. This is found on your portal as well as www.daytonastate.edu. It takes you to the page we just mentioned with the tutorials and contact information for our IT help desk. Know that it is always available and accessible to you should you need it. This is the screen that you get once you have logged in. You will notice holds at the top of the page. Some holds may prevent you from registering for classes. To understand the reason behind the hold, how to get it resolved, and who to contact, simply click on the hold in question. The to-do list includes transactions or documents that need to be completed or submitted. These will not prevent you from registering, but they are action items that need to be taken care of as soon as possible so that they do not delay other transactions and processes, such as financial aid. Much like the holds, simply click on the item and you'll find the details about what is needed and who to contact with questions. The tabs at the top of the page are very important and will be used most frequently. Let's start with the My Academics tab. First, we will look under Enrollment. That is where you will add, drop, or swap classes. Let's try it. Choose Add Classes. You may need to choose a semester. Don't get caught up or confused by the tabs at the top. Simply choose My Requirements as you see here and search. And you will get to a screen to find the classes that are correct to help you fulfill your program requirements. It shows you what areas of your degree that you need to complete. If it shows not satisfied, you need to take that course or courses to complete a requirement. Let's see an example. Simply choose a class, and it will pop up with the course information, days, times, campus. It also shows the instructional method, such as online or hybrid, and the instructor name. Click on Select, then Next. It is just like shopping online. When you choose a course, it goes into your shopping cart. Proceed to step 2 of 3. You need to read this information and then click on Agree to complete your enrollment. If there are any holds, go back and review the holds to resolve the situation. Another way to do a course search is to go to www.daytonastate.edu and select Course Search from the quick links. Under the graduation option, you will see the details about submitting your graduation application or the status of the application. My Classes is where you will view your actual course schedule. This is also where you will view your final grades for the semester under View My Grades. Planning and Progress is a degree audit. It shows the requirements for the major we have on file for you and courses you have completed towards that program. If you feel that major is incorrect, you need to work with academic advising to discuss your major and to make any changes. The What If report provides you with the option to compare what you have taken and how those courses and credits apply to other programs. For example, if you are in an AA degree program but want to know how the courses you have taken apply to our culinary AS degree, you could use this option. Let's review the My Finances tab. This is your student account information. You can review your account. You can also enroll in a payment plan if necessary. This is also where you can make a payment online. Any questions about billing and fees should be directed to student accounts. If you are a financial aid recipient, this is where you can view your information. You would find details about your FAFSA and your status. Questions about your aid and its status should be directed to financial aid. Under the Resources tab, you'll see highlighted recommended services, and it provides a quick one-stop shop to find these departments and their contact information quickly and easily. Under the My Profile tab, you can update and keep current some of the most important information we have on file for you. This includes your mailing address, your phone number, and alternate numbers, and your alternate email to your school-issued Falcon Mail. It is essential that you keep this information up to date so that if we need to communicate with you, we can do so. We can recommend that you check your school-issued Falcon Mail email account daily, if not twice a week, to ensure that you're not missing any communications from the college or your instructors. You can also manage your password and include permission to share your information. Due to federal privacy laws, college personnel cannot share student record or financial information with anyone other than the student. If you need someone to have proxy and to be delegate access to your records, it must be documented. Again, instructions of how to set up a delegate can be found on www.daytonastate.edu/help under Add a Delegate to View Your Information. Under My Key Links, there are two very important links that are also found at the top of the page. One is Falcon Mail. Your Falcon Mail is a school-issued account and is the primary method of communication the college uses. Again, due to federal privacy laws, staff and faculty cannot respond to grades or records and account-related questions to emails sent from outside providers, such as Gmail and Yahoo. We can, however, discuss them when you send your inquiries via your Falcon Mail email account because it requires a login to authenticate the user. Again, we cannot stress enough to check this email account daily or at a minimum twice a week to stay informed and on top of communications. The other link is the Falcon Online Course Access. This link will take you to Falcon Online, which is the course management system the college uses for classes. Each class you take has a shell. Depending on the course and its format, you may find simply a syllabus and grades, or much more content. You may be required to submit homework or take tests using Falcon Online. If you take a hybrid or online course, the majority, if not all, of your work will be completed using Falcon Online. Again, if you have any questions or concerns about how to use Falcon Online, visit the www.daytonastate.edu/help page, where you can find videos and tutorials. You can also contact our IT help desk with technical questions as well. One other detail worth mentioning. You will see on the help page that there is a link for Office 365. A benefit of being a Daytona State College student is free access to Microsoft Office. You can either use Office 365, which includes Word, PowerPoint, Excel, and cloud storage via your Falcon Mail email account, or you can download the full version of Microsoft Office for free on up to 5 devices, PC or Mac. Make sure you take advantage of that, since most of your work will use these software programs. If you need help loading it to your device or have questions, simply contact our IT help desk. They can even help you install it on your device. Now, look at the academic calendar link. This page provides important dates such as the first and last day of classes, the add drop deadlines, withdrawal deadlines, and college holidays. Make sure you are aware of these published dates. You are responsible for knowing them. Finally, our suggestion is to surf your portal. Check out what's offered and available and how easy it is to access information. Hopefully you found this video helpful. We are glad that you are here, and we hope you have a great semester.